So I think we were talking about the questionnaire and how we are going to construct our questionnaires. And I said from the beginning that you have to select specific issues and start conducting your questionnaire, even if we are talking about 5 to 10 questions. But you have to select a special or a specific issue related to public opinions, related to public opinions, related to the attitude of people. That's all. So you have, you can select political issue, you can select social issue. Social issue, for example, or political issue or municipality issues regarding the municipality. You want to test the people about the service of the municipality. You want to test the people about something related to the governments, something related to the service provided by the NGOs, something related to election, something related to Jawal, something related to Baltel, anything. So you can just select one of these issues and try to develop a questionnaires, and then we are going to understand how we select the sample. As we said, we have different type of samplings, random sampling and probability sample and non-probability. So it's up you, it's up to you. It depends upon the issue that already what you selected. Understood? And next week we are going to present, these what, these issues. And you already have your own 10 or 15 questions, 6 questions, 8 questions. You can use the social media, you can use your Facebook. Anyone who have shared with you, he can answer your questions. That's why you have to select a specific issue related to what? To the one that you has a like or has sharing your Facebook, okay? And after that, you are going to collect these data and give us results about the public opinions toward the specific issues. Understood? That's why we are still talking about questionnaire constructing. How we are going to construct questionnaires, and then we talk about sampling. These are what we are saying, and I discussed it, no? Or I discussed some of it in the previous lecture. We said these are something that sometimes we have to pay too much attention to that or to avoid it. When we talk about semantics or we talk about biased wording or talking about timing and context, political correctness and answer categories. These issues or these categories or these elements, we have to understand how we are going to avoid it in whenever we start conducting our questionnaires. For example, semantics. What do you mean by semantics? That means when you start wording your questionnaire, you start formulating your questionnaire, you have to understand that sometimes you are placing or setting some words, and this word, it has many interpretations. So you have to be alert. You know, the word that you already stated, it has different interpretation, it has different meanings. This is what we call semantics. Understood? Like? Mm-hmm. So, whenever we talk about semantics, the problem, wording the questions on a questionnaire is a time-consuming process. Yani the most difficult things in conducting your research is how to formulate your questionnaires. So sometimes you are exerting too much effort. So what he's saying, wording the questions on a questionnaire is a time-consuming process. And it is unusual for a questionnaire to go through multiple drafts to achieve a maximum clarity. Yani sometimes you don't have time to distribute your questionnaires in your respondents or in your sample, then after that you are discovering some problems. So what you are going to say, okay, I'll withdraw the questionnaire, I'm going to modify it, then I will go to redistribute it. The respondents won't allow you to do that. They don't have enough time to receive you. They don't have enough time. That's why from the beginning, you have to understand that whenever you start distributing your questionnaire, you already what avoided all these matters. Huh. Research show that people often think something is a good idea, but do not think it would work. Many times we have something or we have an idea and we are saying it is very good. It is a good idea. But whenever it comes to the application, it will be unapplicable. Here, nowadays, I have your classmates, they already graduate, they are undergraduating, they are conducting their researches. So they are bringing to me some titles about what research they are going to conduct. The only thing they have the title. Did you read anything about the previous studies? Did you read any articles? Did you read any paper? No. What you are going to write, I want to write about, for example, e-shopping. E-shopping, it can be a theoretical title. You can find it in books, in articles, in previous studies, in papers, in references, and many references. So you have to focus on what type of e-shopping you are talking about. Who's your respondents? E-shopping for youth, the e-shopping and its effect on the youth attitude, for example. How e-shopping affects the attitude of your classmates, the attitude of consumers. But whenever you just say, okay, it is e-shopping, is that a title? Okay, this is what we are meaning. So wording. Research show that the people often think something is a good idea, but do not think it would work. Another related problem is how respondents might interpret the word limit or curtail. Sometimes the word, it has many limitations, many curtails, many abbreviations. So we have to clarify all these type of clarification or limitations or boundaries. Avoid biased wording. Sometimes whenever we conduct our research, we use what we call biased wording. What does that mean? I have my own objective. You know, the researcher sometimes, he's not objective. He's not objective. So he wants the respondents to answer the questions related to his objective. So he wants to skew. He wants to school the respondent to answer something related to his what? Objective. He already believes something and he wants all the audience to wear to what? To support him. This is what we call bias wording. So we are selecting specific words in order to what? To accomplish our objective. That means we are not objective that much. Questionnaire should avoid a question that use a highly charged word to elicit a particular responses. For example, I want to conduct a questionnaire regarding, for example, Jerusalem divisions for East and West. East for Arab, for Palestinian, and West for I can formulate words, or I can conduct a questionnaire in order to have all respondents answer to support my what? My own notions, my own feelings. That means I am with the division of Jerusalem. So sometimes if you pass by many questionnaires, from the first question to the end, you will find out that those people or the researcher are behind to what? To have his own objective, not to answer or to follow up the reality, the real data that he's going to get from respondents. Understood what do you mean here?
All the answers are the same.
All answer will lead you to his objective, to the researcher objectives. And it is easy to be what? To be made. Especially when we talk about politics. Especially when we were told to talk about politics. If you remember in the last election, I think 2006 or 2005, 2006, when they had the polls and surveys regarding who is going to be the winner in the election, and this questionnaires was conducted by specific offices in Birzeit universities, and all the polls they were saying, or the conclusion they were saying that Fatah will be the dominance. The second day, it was what? Something else. It is the conclusion. It was not even near to the truth. A big gap. Big gap between who won and the one supposed to win according to them. That means what? Here what we call the bias wording. We were not objective in that matters. Okay? We are not saying the truth. So in a survey, such a statement and the questions are an indication that advocacy research is being conducted. Advocacy research. يعني, what do you mean by advocacy research? That supported research. I'm conducting research to support my opinions. This is what we call advocacy research. اللي هي أبحاث التأييد بسموها. عشان يعني أي حاجة تأيد اللي احنا بنحكي فيه. That's the questionnaire is good to promote. That's the questionnaire is good to promote a product or service. They are supporting a specific product or supporting what? A specific service. Understood? Understood? Timing and context. We have to pay too much attention to the time that we are going to conduct our research. When we are going to conduct our research. For example, if I'm talking about private sectors, I'm talking about, for example, Jawal. I want to conduct a research regarding the profitability of this organization. If I start from the beginning, from, for example, January, it will give me the result of January. Yeah, but do you think Jawal is going to conduct 12 researches? So I can divide the year into 4 quarters at least. So the first quarter will give us indications, then the second quarter will give us indications. But I can't conduct the research of the second quarter related to the first quarter. I can't conduct a research in the second quarter related to what? Or the third quarter related to 1 quarter. That means I have to pay too much attention to what? To the time I'm conducting the research. For example, we have, in this month, we have the Mother Day events. So, if someone he needs to conduct research, he can conduct it now in order to predict what the people they are going to buy, they are going to celebrate this event or not. But they are not waiting up till 4 months or five months in order to ask them what happened in the Mother Day. Okay? Today we are talking about elections. But some people they are interested where? In the Czech borders. They are talking about cement and steel and the prices is already shoot up. So always we have to pay attention for these matters. For example, I want to ask my student here. I want to ask you, do you want to buy a car? The results, 95% no. Because we have no money. Okay? But you may, after 1 week, you start buying it. You already answered no. Why? Because we are talking about specific situation. But later on, this situation, it may what? Change. You may have a job. You may have a gift. If your father is rich and he already passed away, he will leave you big money and you can do whatever you want. So always we have to pay too much attention for the time that you are conducting your research. And for example, I want to ask another example. I want to understand the role played by the local government on the economic situations. So this is the time that I have, I have to conduct this research. But I can't conduct this research in 2006 or 2007 because we were what? Under siege. But now we can conduct a research. I want to understand the big dilemma that the internal employees in the public sector they are facing. So I have in the beginning to specify the date you are conducting a research for the first government when Abu Ammar he was already existed, or in the second government we already passed by many or five ministers of health education, of health ministers. So you want to conduct your research in what era? That's why we ask the researcher, and you have to specify, you have to be specific. You are evaluating what? You are evaluating the present minister, or you are evaluating the previous one, or you are evaluating the first one. We already passed by how many ministers we passed by from 1993 till now. So if you want to be specific, you have to follow the timing. The time is very important. To say it was effective performance, you have to tell me when you have this effective performance. In 1993 or in 1996 or in 2000, 2005, in 2013. You understood now? ما بقدر أنا أقول عن المينستر هذا الآن الجديد أعمل له conducting research الآن عشان أعمل له بدي أحط التاريخ اللي هو له شهرين فيه بس مزبوط؟ معناته أنا اللي بدي أعمل evaluation بعمل evaluation لمين؟ to the previous minister. طب هو the previous minister هذا إيش كان قبله؟ بدك تعمل كمان إيه عن الفترة اللي كان فيها وضحت؟ You have to pay much attention to the timing and the context of your questionnaire. Responses to survey questionnaire are influenced by events, and this should be taken into consideration when reviewing the result of survey. Events. You are a student now, so if I conduct a research with you are answering me as a student, but tomorrow you are an employee, so your answer will be different from today. Large organizations such as Microsoft count balance the effect of one-time events by conducting quarterly survey. This is technique we call it benchmarking. And in each quarter we have our own survey in order to understand something related to our business. The political correctness. Political correctness. Sometimes, and after you formulate your questionnaires, and you start distributing it, the respondents, sometimes they have enough information or they are an expert and they won't offend the researcher. They won't offend him. What does that mean? They won't offend him. Sometimes he stated a wrong questions. Sometimes the students stating a wrong questions, but politically for the respondents he won't offend you, he won't tell you that it is a bad questionnaire, so he has a diplomatic answers. This is what we call a political correctness. يعني انا ما بديش اخش في مين اقول له يعني انت والله انه الكويستينير تبعك سيء ورديء وانت مش فانا بس اجاوبه شغلات مالها بدبلوماسية وضحت؟ هذا بسموها correctness political correctness وهذا بتصير كثير مع شباب من اللي هم ابحاث التخرج خلص بقول لك طالب بده يخلص ومشيك فبتكون الريزلتس مالها والconclusion sometimes inaccurate. Another problem with the questionnaire design involves the question that that tend to elicit a correct responses. This is called a courtesy bias. يعني it is a matter of bias, but we call it what? A courtesy bias. تحيز لكن ايه؟ بلطف يعني. Respondents often choose answers that won't offend the interviewers and that reflect mainstream thinking. Survey of public relations practitioners about the value of research also show a degree of courtesy bias in choosing the political correct next answer. يعني أنا بصير من ضمن الأربع إجابات بروح بجاوبك حاجة إيه بدبلوماسية، واحدة منهم بدبلوماسية عشان ترضي غرورك أو ترضي الاستبيان اللي أنت إيه اللي أنت عامله. واضح؟ أنتوا يعني don't يعني think that all our students they are effective enough in conducting their questionnaires whenever they start distributing it for their graduation research. Not all of them are the same, they have the same capabilities. So sometimes the respondents, they what? They are complementing them or choosing specific answer to satisfy your need. That means they are not what? Signing the right answers. Researcher to avoid politically correct answers by making a questionnaire confidential, confidential, and by promising anonymity to the people who are surveyed, because employees perceive the public relations department to be a part of management. يعني sometimes you are a public relations practitioner and you want to distribute questionnaires in order to understand that your employee, your internal employee, they are satisfied or dissatisfied. What do you think the people or your employee they will say? Sometimes all of them they will say we are satisfied. Why? Because they are considering the public relations practitioner is one of the top level of management. So they are complimenting you. They can't say the truth. وضحت؟ وضحت؟ You are a part of management. I know at least you are going to save one and once they are talking like that. So they are, sometimes you have the fears from the top level of management to say the truth. So you are using the political correctness. إجابات دبلوماسية، ما احنا عارفين الصحيح. عندكم جودة، عندنا جودة. عندكم الإمكانيات المتاحة، يا سلام على الإمكانيات. وضحت كيف الفرق؟ هذه هي الـ diplomatic answers. No, here he gives us the answer here. Researcher tried to avoid political correctness answer by making questionnaire confidential. He will say in his questionnaire that these information are confidential and you don't have to write your name. This is what happens with our students whenever they start what? Evaluating their professors. You don't know the names and at least you are far away from him and the doctor he will not understand who is the one who said yes or no or agree or disagree. So if you make your questionnaire is confidential without names, without titles, you can understand what you can get what a real information. Understood? Understood? Inshallah. الانسر كاتيجوريز. الانسر كاتيجوريز. Sometimes saying yes or no it's a wrong question. يعني we don't have to use yes or no along our questionnaires. Sometimes yes or no can't be answered.
Sometimes you need
evaluation questions. يعني and sometimes you don't have alternatives. You have just yes or no. يعني if you ask someone do you have do you have a strategic plan? You can't say agree or disagree or very much agree or like that. Do you have yes or no? Because I'm talking about something supposed to have one answer. Yes or no. Male or female. We don't have to say categories. especially where in Gaza. But outside is big different culture. So whenever you talk about gender, you are talking about many categories. Others. Okay? So it depends upon what? The type of question, the culture of the respondent that you are going to what? To focus on. So, for example, if I ask you, do you drink Coca-Cola? Huh? Yes. The answer here is yes or no. Okay? So I can from selecting specific sample to understand that the students here, 80% of them, they are drinking Coca-Cola. Okay? Here I'm just what? Talking about attitudes or opinions. But if I want to understand how many bottles of Coca-Cola they are drinking, it can't be to set a question yes or no. I have to make categories from 1 to 3 bottles a day, from 3 to 6 bottles a week, from 9 to 10 or 12 bottles a year. Yeah, understood? So if I'm talking about figures, I have to make categories. If you want to ask your respondents about income level, about his income, you can't talk about $5,000. But if you say from 2 to 4, 2 to 5, that means you give them already what? Range. Sometimes some people, they won't say their ages, especially ladies. If you ask them, how old are you? They will say no. They will not answer. But if you have to put range from 30 to 40, she will may. Huh? Sure answer. Okay? So sometimes we have to follow the answer categories. We have to use some categories for your different questions. Okay? So answer categories also can skew the questionnaire. برضو بتحرف مجال الكويشنين هاي الأذهان. It is important that answer choices are provided that a cover range of opinions. So in general, yes or no questions are not very good for examining respondent perceptions and attitudes. يعني if you ask someone about his perception, how he perceives things, about his perception about specific political issues or attitudes, can't be to ask him yes or no. So you need to what? To make categories, especially when we talk about attitudes and perceptions or opinions. Yes or no provide a little feedback on a strength and weakness of respondents' opinion. Understood? Another way of designing a numeric scale is to pinpoint a respondent's belief attitudes is to use a 5-point scale, اللي احنا بنسميها sometimes a Likert scales. يعني this is the best whenever we talk about attitudes or perceptions or public opinion to talk about Likert scales. Likert scale consists of 5 scales from 1 to 5. Agree, very much agree, in neutral, disagree, very much disagree. So you have many what? Many levels. So your respondents, he can select the type of scale that he is going or matching him. So now we have example here. We have example. How would you evaluate the company's effort? And how you would evaluate the Islamic University efforts you informed about job benefits? About student benefits. How would you evaluate them? We can't say yes or no. How would you evaluate them? So you should have what? Categories. Why? Because the answer is supposed to be different from 1 to 1. Some students will be what? They will say it is an excellent effort. Some, it is bad efforts. Some, neutral efforts. It depends. Because some of our students, they don't even attend the classes. So they can say excellence. Or he may say bad because he did not attend. So how I will force a student he did not participate in my lecture to what? To evaluate his doctor. Imagine if we have, like the previous semester, I have more than 91 students in marketing. How many students they were attended? يعني maximum 50. لا maximum 50. تمام؟ So what about the other 40? How they evaluate their doctors?
It's unfair.
And some of them they are attending today, some of them they are absent tomorrow. Attending. So that means we don't have a fair results. So how would you evaluate the company effort? We have to give more than one skills. One being low rating and five being a high rating. هي احنا هذا اللي هو النمبر سكيل دائما 1 2 3 4 5 that means 1 means 20% 2 40% 60% 80% and 5 it be 100%. Now we have before constructing our questionnaires we have some guidelines. Advices for you to whenever if you want to have an effective questionnaire. Number one, determine the type of information that's needed. You have to determine what type of information you need. For example, and if I ask you, I told you now, you have to select your specific issues and you have to start conducting or stating some questions. If we talk about any things related to politics, about the election, if I ask you to state five questions, it is easy for you to state it now. But if I ask you to state 10 questions, you need information. But if I ask you to have 20 questions, you need more. So the more you are going to details, the more you need information. But if I ask you, just state five questions, you can do it now. The more you need. So you have to understand what type of information you needed from the beginning. But to understand what type of information we need, we have to state our objective. What is the main objective of my research? In order to what? To draw the way that you are going to pass by. My objective means what? My road. Where I'm going to go. Where I'm going to reach. This is my main objective. Then decide which group will receive the questionnaire. Who are your respondents? مين السامبل تبعك؟ Segments. Your target group, you have to sit from the beginning in order to what? To understand what type of words you are going to use. So if you are dealing with educated people, your vocabulary, your terms supposed to what? To match their education. If they are an ordinary people and you are for example, in shopping malls, your question is supposed to be very simple and easy to be what? To be understood because you are dealing with consumers. You don't understand exactly their educational level or their income or any. Decide on the size of the sample. 5% enough, 1% enough, 5 people is enough, 10 person is enough. It depends upon what the issue you are tackling, what type of issue you are handling. It depends upon the total population. If it is large, I'm going to sample. If it is a small population, I can't what go to sampling. Use a closed-end questions. You have to use a closed-ended multiple choice. Answer as often as possible. And always, whenever you ask a question, give some answers. Don't leave the respondent to answer the way they likes. Why? Because if he has more than 20 answers for one question, That means you are talking about one person. If we are talking about 100 persons and everyone he add 5 points, how many points you are going to get? Million? So you have from the beginning to state your what? Your answer. And if you have a fear that you are not able to complete it, you can say others. And after you state five answers, you can say others. Okay? So always we have to go far away from the open questions. We don't prefer the open questions. هيعمل لك مقال صفحة. طب إن لو عندي 500 respondents يعني مش هقدر أجاري إيش اللي بيعملوه. Understood? Use categories when asking questions about age, education, age and income. تمام؟ Measuring intensity of feeling. Measuring intensity of feeling satisfied. Very satisfied or dissatisfied instead of yes or no. ما تقول له satisfied ولا لا yes or no لا. تقول له satisfied, very satisfied, dissatisfied. اللي هو using ايش تو ايش الكاتيجوري. Avoid ambiguous words and phrases that may confuse the respondents. اللي احنا سميناها توي what we call semantics. Avoid ambiguous words. Any words and you feel that it is vague, don't try to use it because it has different interpretation, so they may give you incorrect answers. Don't ask double-barreled questions. Some of these guidelines, I brought it from your present book, 2011. Some of these guidelines. And I will tell you later why I took this chapter from the previous book, not from the one you have. Okay? Because it was too small. In the same time, he's talking about something regarding evaluation, and evaluation supposed to be big enough to what to be handled later on. As we said, race, it ended with evaluation. So he ended the evaluation in the same chapter. Okay? But in that chapter, he gave us one chapter for evaluation. Okay? So, don't ask double-barreled questions. شوف ايش بسموها double barreled questions. ايش يعني؟ Would you like هي السؤال would you like management meetings once a month or bi-monthly meetings enough or bi-monthly meeting enough؟ So اعطاك ايش هنا؟ To answer. That means if you want to state this type of a question, you have to state two questions. Because he may have two answers. وضحت الفكرة وين؟ So always try to be specific. And you can divide it into two questions instead of one question. Remember to consider the context and the placement of the questions. اللي حتى حكينا عنها at time. Don't ask loaded questions. Loaded questions. Is management do it all can? To communicate with you? Is management do what all they can to communicate with you? هذا سؤال. والله مجلس الإدارة مجلس الجامعة بيعمل كل اللي بوسع. طب أنا ايش عرفني اللي بيعمل بوسع ولا بنص ولا بربع. وضح السؤال ماله؟ صعب الإجابة عليه. So don't ask loaded questions. Pre-test. يعني before your final distribution of your questionnaires, you have in the beginning to pre-test your questionnaire. So if you have specific problems, you can modify it before the final distribution. That's why sometimes we seek what we call a referees committee. لجنة للتحكيم الاستبانة دكاترة professional people. بسموهم مرات الريفريز بسموهم الجيدي بسموهم البانل. Attach a letter. شوف محلها الكلام هذا. Attach a letter showing how much important the respondent's answer are. يعني always you have to show يعني always in the first page you have to show your respondents that his answer is very important to you or else you will not able to finish your what your graduation. يعني imagine you have a graduation research and the respondents they don't feel and always you are going to him and say tomorrow, tomorrow, tomorrow. So from the beginning you have to write or attach a letter showing him that you are in a badly need for this answer. Understood? When mailing, يعني sometimes we have many tools in distributing our questionnaires. Sometimes you will be the one who moved from place to place, and sometimes you send your questionnaire by what? By mail. يعني as long as we are talking about Gaza, we are not dealing with mails. I'm not talking about email, about mails. البريد. But in the in United States, whenever we talk about 51 states, or in Egypt, we are talking about many governorates. Sometimes you send your email, your questionnaire by what? By mail. What he's saying here, يعني if you are using this way, huh? When mailing, hand stamp the unique with envelope. يعني حاول تستخدم الستام تبعك اللي انت مستخدمه، خليه هيك النوع من اليونيكنس، يعني حاجه لها منظر جمالي، ستام حلو اللي انت باعت فيه الايميل اللي حاطه هين، او هيك بريفربلي كومراتيف ستامز. ناس من اللي بيحبوا ايش؟ يحتفظوا في ايش بنسميهم احنا؟ الستامز تبعت البريد، الطوابع. يعني خليه ستامب حلو على اساس في ناس بيحتفظوا فيه فبيحبوا انه يستخدموا شغلات ابعث بالستامبس. طيب ايش بقول كمان هنا؟ فولو اب يور فيرست ميلينج. اذا كان اف يو ار يوزينج ميلز يو هاف تو فولو اب. يعني ناو ليتس سي ذات وي اوريدي ديستريبيوتد اور كويشنير باي ميل. اوكي؟ افتر 3 دايز اي هاف تو فولو اب. I can say, did you receive? Did you not? What happened? Like that. You don't have to wait 1 month waiting your respondent answer or he received or not. You have to be sure. So after 3 days, you have to what? To start following up what you already what? Mailed. Finally, send out more questionnaire. Send out more questionnaire than you think necessary. Enclosed than you think necessary. يعني for example I want from this company I have 5 respondents in this company. So whenever you send your questionnaire send 10 questionnaire. Sometimes he will lose it. Sometimes he carry the questionnaire in his home and he's not returning back. Sometimes he have some mistake when he's writing. Sometimes they are discovering that there are another employee supposed to answer your questions, but you don't know. So the general manager, sometimes they redistribute the questionnaire for the specific person that's supposed to answer your questionnaire. So instead of sending 5, I can send what? 10. It is a time savings. Finally, enclose a reward. If you are, we are talking about mails, send reward, even يعني a small gift. He will feel embarrassed. The respondent sometimes they feel embarrassed if you send what we call a gift, small gift, to show him how much you are, how much important your what, your questionnaire. So sometimes you will feel anything, bullpen, anything. Flash, anything you like, just to show him that you are in a badly need for that questionnaire, and at the same times, something they may embarrassing him. وضحت؟ بخجل على حاله الواحد لما انت يعني وضحت؟ كويسه هذه الشغلات، في ناس بيعتبروها نوع من الكوربشن، هي مش كوربشن. هو هذا كويشنير بده يجاوبه خلاص انا مالي انا واضح؟ ممكن as different culture we consider it a matter of corruption. It is no. My aims is to what to collect or retrieve my questionnaires. So I want to encourage him. These almost the main guidelines of whenever we start conducting and what sending or retrieving our questionnaires. Do you have anything, any questions with this regard? Do you have?